Hello friends, welcome back to the series of lecture. This is the 40th lecture of the series of Indian Evidence Act. In this lecture, we would start with section 14. Section 14-15 mein, you have to read the Bayer Act carefully and understand what they are trying to tell you and see the illustrations. Now please take out section 14. They are saying, facts showing the existence of any state of mind, such as intention, knowledge, good faith, negligence, rashness, ill will or goodwill towards any particular person. Now they are saying any particular person. Matlab kisi ek vishesh vyakti ki or. Fact showing the existence of any state of mind. Now you see that the list they have given you, it is not exhaustive. They are talking about the any state of mind, and any state of mind can be an intention, and intention can be of different kinds. Intention to produce a particular consequence, fraudulent intention, dishonest intention, different kinds of intention. Similarly, they are saying knowledge, good faith, negligence, rashness, ill will, goodwill. Now, isme aur bhi add ho sakta hai, jaise malice. So, this list is not exhaustive. So, any other kind of state of mind can be fall in this. Now, they are saying that any fact which shows that particular state of mind towards a particular person, then that fact will be relevant. Any fact which shows a particular state of mind towards a particular person, that fact will be relevant. Ab chota sa point samajh lo aap. Example le lo. Jaise maan lo A ne murder kiya B ka. A has murdered B. Now the question is whether A has the intention to cause death. Now intention to cause death is relevant fact or fact in issue? It is the fact in issue. Yaad karo aap fact in issue ka definition. Intention to cause death. So knowledge, intention, these are the mens rea. And they will all be fact in issue. Now what they are saying is any fact which go on to show the intention of the person. Any fact which goes on to show the intention of the person towards that particular victim, towards that particular person, that particular victim will be a relevant fact. Ab common sense se aap socho, then how will you infer the intention? Ab intention is the state of mind and you cannot get inside the mind and explore. So you have to look the intention by the external conduct and behavior of the party, of the accused, because whatever I have in my mind, you cannot come to know unless I express that in some manner. You cannot come to know unless I express in some manner, express that in some manner. So therefore the examination will always be that as to whether there is some external body behavior, physical behavior, which shows your intention. Now, for example, there is a fact that at the time of shooting upon B, A shouted that I will kill you. Now this is the statement that I will kill you. Now this statement is what? It is a fact. Of this fact, is it not mentioned manifestly that the intention of causing death? This statement is manifesting his intention of causing death. Or maybe A shot upon B point blank on the head or on the chest. So the fact that he shot on the head, that shows his intention. The fact that he shot upon his chest, that shows the intention. But suppose he shot upon his legs, pairon par goli chalai, that is not showing his intention to cause death. Shooting upon leg is not showing intention to cause death. So any fact which shows the intention, any fact which shows the intention to cause death will be a relevant fact. Now how will you show the intention? Any fact, koi bhi common sense ka fact soch lo aap. Common sense mein koi bhi fact ho sakta hai. The fact may be that he shot upon some vital part of the body. The fact may be that he gave two blood shots. Ab aapne do bar goli chalai, accused ne do bar goli chalai, means what? Your intention to cause death is there. So that way, if you see दो बार गोली चलाई और उसके बॉडी पार्ट्स पर चलाई, एयर फायरिंग नहीं थी. सो इन दैट वेज यू सी एनी फैक्ट which is the matter of a state of mind, can be known by some external conduct, some external behavior, by some external manifestation. Those external manifestation, the conduct, behavior, etc., or maybe some statement that you made, that accused made, all these may go on to prove the particular state of mind towards the particular victim. So that is what broadly they are saying. Whatever they are saying here is a common sense thing. Agar section nahi hota tab bhi, we are able to infer. Fact showing the existence of any state of mind, such as intention, knowledge, good faith, negligence, rashness, ill will or goodwill towards any particular person, or showing the existence of any state of body or bodily feeling, are relevant. When the existence of any such state of mind or body or bodily feeling is an issue or relevant. So, jab aap state of mind, state of body, bodily feeling ki aap baat kar rahe ho, aur agar wo kisi case mein, that state of mind, state of body or bodily feeling, etc., if that itself a relevant fact, or that in itself a fact in issue, then any fact which shows that particular state of mind, state of body or bodily feeling, that will also be relevant. Look out some illustrations. Illustration A. A is accused of receiving stolen goods, knowing them to be stolen. It is section 411 IPC. It is section 411 IPC, jahan par you are liable for receiving stolen goods with the knowledge or reason to believe that it was stolen. Now, A ke upar agar charge hai that he has committed the offense of 411, and the allegation is that at the time when he received the goods, he had the knowledge that the goods are stolen. Now, any fact which shows the knowledge. The knowledge kya hai? That is the fact in issue. That knowledge that the goods are stolen, that is a fact in issue, because it is mens rea for 411. It is the mens rea for 411. So any fact which go on to show the knowledge, it is a relevant fact. Now aage dekhiye. The fact that at the same time, the fact that at the same time he was in possession of many other stolen articles is relevant, as tending to show that he knew each and all of the articles of which he was in possession to be stolen. So that is quite logical. For example, you give a mobile to me and I take a mobile from you. Later on, a charge was made against me that I took this mobile with the knowledge that it is a stolen mobile. Now, any fact which shows that I have a knowledge. Now, suppose jis samay mujhe pakda gaya, us samay I was found in possession of 15-20 stolen mobile phones. Then obviously this fact shows that I am dealing with this stolen mobile phones. Now, mere paas 15-20 stolen mobile phones hain, aur ek aur mobile phone jo maine liya hai, that is what, with the knowledge that it is a stolen property. Kyunki 15-20 mobile mere paas hain jo ki stolen hain, 15-20 mobile mere paas hain aur mujhko pata hai sare ke sare stolen hain, then ye jo mobile phone liya, ye bhi knowledge ke sath liya hoga. And therefore the fact that I found in the possession of several mobile phones which are stolen, that goes on to prove that this mobile phone also, when I took, I had the knowledge that it is a stolen one. Ab illustration C dekh lo. Jo B hai usko hum baad mein dekhenge explanation 2 se relate karke. Now you see illustration C. Ye section aap illustration se hi ज्यादातर समझ पाओगे. The more you read the illustration, the more you will understand this section. A sues B. A sues B for damage done by a dog of B's. Dog of B's which B knew to be ferocious. अब B को पता था कि that मेरा कुत्ता खतरनाक है. My dog is ferocious. Then also he was negligent with the dog, and therefore A was bitten by the dog. Yeah, for A has been injured by the dog. So A has filed a suit against B for what? For the damages. Now the facts that the dog previously bitten X, Y, Z, and that they had made complaints to be are relevant. Now you see, what are the facts that you are examining here? The knowledge that the dog is ferocious. That is also a fact and issue in the case. You thought of negligence ke liye. It is a breach of duty. A breach of duty tab hoga jab aapko knowledge hoga us baat ka. Your dog is ferocious. You have knowledge of that. So you have to careful with the dog. अगर आपको पता होगा कि आपका डॉग फरूसियस है तभी तो आप कॉशियस होंगे. अब किसी को नॉलेज होती है किसी पर्टिकुलर इंसिडेंट से दैट हिज डॉग इज फरूसियस, देन इट इज हिज ड्यूटी टू बी कॉशियस अबाउट हिज डॉग. ही मस्ट नॉट बी नेग्लिजेंट अबाउट हिज डॉग. वो चेन वैन या बेल्ट से जिससे भी बांध रहे हैं दैट शुड बी टाइटली कॉट और होल्डेड और टाइड. अब यहाँ पर फैक्ट एंड इशू क्या है? That you have the knowledge and you are negligent about the handling of dog. Now, how did you have the knowledge? Any fact which goes on to prove that you had the knowledge. Now, मान लो किसी को पहले उसने अटैक किया हो और बाद में जब इंसिडेंट हुआ एक के साथ तो उसमें कोई सी है उसके साथ भी हो चुका तो सी came to the court and gave his testimony that I have warned B earlier, so that will show that B is having a knowledge. Similarly here, the fact that the dog has previously bitten X, Y and Z and that they had made complaints to B are relevant. Now see illustration D. The question is whether A, the acceptor of a bill of exchange, knew that the name of the payee was fictitious. अगर फिक्सीशियस है तो फ्रॉड में फंसेगा वो. द फैक्ट दैट ए हैड एक्सेप्टेड अदर बिल्स ड्रॉन इन द सेम मैनर बिफोर दे कुड हैव बीन ट्रांसमिटेड टू हिम बाय द पेई इफ द पेई हैड बीन ए रियल पर्सन इज रेलिवेंट एज शोइंग दैट ए न्यू दैट द पेई वॉज ए फिक्सीशियस पर्सन. मतलब पहले भी उसने इस तरह के बिल ऑफ एक्सचेंज दिए थे. सो एवरी टाइम यू नो दैट and every time the fact suggested that you know that it was fictitious, तो अभी भी जो आपने दिया है तो इसकी नॉलेज आपको है. अब इलस्ट्रेशन ही देखो आप. A is accused of defaming B by publication and imputation intended to harm the reputation of B. A ने defamation किया है B का and the defamation he has the intention to make harm to the reputation of B. He has the intention to harm the reputation of B. The fact of previous publication by A respecting B showing ill will on the part of A towards B is relevant as proving A's intention to harm B's reputation by the particular publication in question. Now, देखो, what they are saying here is A had made a publication against B. A had made a publication against B. And the allegation is that he has the intention to harm the reputation. Now, earlier also, he had been involved in similar instances or you can call them similar occurrences. Earlier also, he has been involved in similar occurrences towards who? Towards B. Now, in this, A may show his publication in which it will show the ill will towards B. So the chain of instances are there. Chain of instances is there which is suggesting the state of mind that is intention to harm his reputation. So in the present publication, whether he has the intention or not, that can be proved by the fact that he has earlier also he had makes this kind of publication. Now the facts that there was no previous quarrel. Next para. The facts that there was no previous quarrel between A and B and that A repeated the matter complained of as he heard it are relevant as showing that A did not intend to harm the reputation of B. So, ab agar ye prove ho jaye A ka B se koi jhagda nahi tha aur A ne jo kaha hai wo actually usko kisi ne bataya tha aur usi baat ko usne repeat kar diya hai, then that shows his innocence. He had not deliberately made the publication. Someone told to him about A and someone told him A about B and A repeated it. B के बारे में किसी ने A को बताया और A ने उसको repeat किया. So that shows that he did not have intention to cause defamation or not have the intention to harm the reputation of me. But if you saw that earlier also the similar instances he has been making bad publication towards B, that shows his intention to cause harm to B. अब मान लो A ने B को गोली मार दी. अब intention to cause death है कि नहीं? अब body के किस part पर गोली मारा? That is one thing. But otherwise, earlier also A at 2 or 3 instances had tried to kill B. A earlier also at 2 or 3 times tried to kill B, or maybe once he has tried to, or maybe he has shot upon B. So that instance is a fact which suggests similar occurrence. That is the instance is a fact which suggests that A has the intention to kill B in the present instance. So those kind of examples they are talking about. It can be any statement, it can be any conduct, it can be any event, it can be similar occurrences in the past. All that go on to prove the fact that is in the question, the state of mind that is in the question today. Now see F. A is sued by B for fraudulently representing to B that C was solvent, whereby B, being induced to trust C, who was insolvent, suffered losses. मतलब A ने सूट किया B के ऊपर कि तुमने मुझे गलत बताया था that C is solvent, जबकि C was insolvent. Maybe because of that, I gave him money and I lost the money because he was insolvent. So in that case, you have negligently told me and therefore I suffered the losses. अब यहाँ पर what factor you are trying to explore? The fraudulent intention of B to tell A that C is solvent. अब यहाँ पर मैंने थोड़ा उल्टा बोल दिया. A को सू किया है B ने. अब आगे पढ़ो. The fact that at the time when A represented C to be solvent, C was supposed to be solvent by his neighbors and by persons dealing with him is relevant as showing that A made the representation in good faith. Now उसके पड़ोसी जानने वाले, C के जो पड़ोसी जानने वाले थे, सब उसको solvent मानते थे और इसी वजह से A ने भी कह दिया कि वो solvent है. That shows that he has acted in good faith. His intention was not fraudulent. Now let's see H. A is accused of the dishonest misappropriation of property which he had found. And the question is whether when he appropriated it, he believed in good faith that the real owner could not be found. Now suppose you get a mobile phone and you try to find the real owner, that whose phone is this. You try your best and after that you started using this mobile phone. Now later on the mobile phone found, then he explained that I could not find the real owner, then I started this mobile phone for using. I started using this mobile phone. The mobile ke case mein to good faith ho hi nahi sakta, kyunki mobile kiska hai wo to pata chali jayega contacts wagera mein. But for example kisi ke paise gir jate hain ya fir kisi ki ring gir gayi hai, to such kind of things maybe it would be. Watch gir gayi kisi ki, अब किसी की वॉच गिर गई उसको तो पता नहीं पड़ सकता किसकी घड़ी है. अब बहुत एक्सक्लूसिव घड़ी है, काफ़ी महंगी है. अब हो सकता है कि पर्टिकुलर कंपनी में रजिस्टर्ड वगैरह हो, तो इतना एफर्ट्स वो नहीं करता है, उसको जानकारी नहीं है. अब उसने जितनी कोशिश कर सकता था उसने कोशिश की टू फाइंड द रियल ओनर, बट आफ्टर सम टाइम व्हेन ही नॉट फाउंड द रियल ओनर ही स्टार्टेड यूजिंग दैट वॉच. अब व्हेन यू आर प्रोसिक्यूटेड फॉर क्रिमिनल मिसअप्रोप्रिएशन, so there the question arises as to whether you have a good faith or not. Ab aage dekho. The fact that public notice of the loss of the property had been given in the place where A was is relevant as showing that A did not in good faith believe that the real owner of the property, property could not be found. अब मान लो मेरी घड़ी गिर गई कहीं इधर एंड वन ऑफ यू फाउंड इट एंड यू कैप्ट इट विद यू. अब हियर द फर्स्ट लैक ऑफ गुड फेथ इज व्हाट यू शुड गिव दिस टू द पर्सन हु इज लुकिंग आफ्टर दिस प्रमाइसिस. तो घड़ी मिल गई किसी क्लासरूम में तो आपको उधर टीचर या किसी प्रमाइसिस के इंचार्ज को देना चाहिए जिससे अनाउंसमेंट करके उस घड़ी को दे सकें. तो पहला तो गुड फेथ वहीं पर लैकिंग हो जाएगा. अब देन मे बी नेक्स्ट डे आई मेक अनाउंसमेंट दैट यस्टरडे आई लॉस्ट माई वॉच हैज एनीवन सीन देन ऑल्सो यू हैड नॉट गिवन रिटर्न दैट वॉच एंड देन देयर यू स्टार्ट वेयरिंग दैट वॉच एंड यूजिंग इट. सो टेल मी इज इट नॉट एन एबसेंस ऑफ गुड फेथ. अब दिस फैक्ट गोज ऑन टू प्रूव दैट देयर वॉज अ लैक ऑफ गुड फेथ. अब इसको एग्जाम्पल को उल्टा कर लो दैट आफ्टर यू वॉच फाउंड आफ्टर यू फाउंड द वॉच देन यू टोल्ड the in charge of that premises that I have found a watch here. If anyone claims, please send him to me. And you told to your neighbors on the next day in the class and you are showing watch everyone. Or you did not show the watch because agar koi galt wrong person, if any wrong person claim, so you want to hide the watch, just say that I have got a watch but I will give the right person who will tell me the same description of the watch. Because there are chances to that wrong person may claim them. अब किसी ने कोई watch claim नहीं की after that you started using it. अब here बताइए आप that did he is in good faith? Did you are in good faith? Yes, because he has done his reasonable efforts. अब read आगे. The fact that A knew or had reason to believe that the notice was given fraudulently by C, who had heard of the loss of the property and wished to set up a false claim to it, is relevant as showing the fact that A knew of the notice did not disprove A's good faith. अब मान लो आपको घड़ी मिल गई, और फिर आपने जाकर दोस्तों को बताया कि किसकी वॉच मुझे एक घड़ी मिली थी. अब मान लो आपके किसी दोस्त में से किसी ने नोटिस लगा दिया दैट आई हैव लॉस्ट सो एंड सो वॉच एंड यू नो दैट ही इज नॉट इट इज नॉट हिज वॉच ही हैड मेड अ फ्रॉडुलेंट नोटिस टू टेक द वॉच फ्रॉम यू एंड देयरफॉर यू डिड नॉट गिव द वॉच टू हिम. अब बताइए इस सिचुएशन में गुड फेथ है कि नहीं. इन दिस सिचुएशन ऑल्सो देयर इज गुड फेथ. वाई? बिकॉज यू नो पर्सनली दैट द नोटिस इज फॉल्स. But if the notice is true and then you did not give, then you can always say that it is a lack of good faith. Now take out illustration number M, the state of body. The question is what was the state of A's health? The question is what was the state of his health at the time when insurance on his life was affected? At the time when insurance on his life was affected. Statements made by A as to the state of his health at or near the time in question are relevant facts. At or near the time in questions are relevant facts. Now, देखो, what was the state of his health? Now, A may have told people that I am suffering from so and so problem. And if he has told that to people and tomorrow the question is what was his health? Then will not these statement can be used to prove the state of his bad health? अब देखो कई बार क्या होता है कि इंश्योरेंस करवाते हैं, हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस करवाते हैं, तो someone is suffering from some earlier diseases. तो जब उसको एजेंट को बताते हैं या तो वो उस डिजीज की वजह से इंश्योरेंस करता नहीं है हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस, या फिर कर देते हैं तो वो प्रीमियम हाई रखते हैं. कई बार क्या करते हैं ये कमीशन की वजह से एजेंट जो डिजीज अर्लियर डिसीज है किसी कस्टमर ने बताई है तो उसको डिस्क्लोज नहीं करते हैं वो कंपनी में. वो डॉक्यूमेंट रख लिया, डिस्क्लोज नहीं किया, बिकॉज वाई उनका जो कमीशन है वो मारा जाएगा, रिजेक्ट हो गई तो पॉलिसी. डिस्क्लोज नहीं करते. अब एट द टाइम ऑफ क्लेमिंग दैट इंश्योरेंस क्वेश्चन अरोज होगा कि उसकी जो प्रीवियस कंडीशन दैट वॉज अर्लियर टू दैट पॉलिसी, जो पॉलिसी ली थी उससे पहले. सो ही इज हैविंग ही डन फ्रॉड अपॉन द कंपनी, बाई नॉट डिस्क्लोजिंग द हिज सिकनेस। तो ये गलती एजेंट वर्क की होगी, बट अल्टीमेटली द पर्सन सफर और कंपनी क्लेम नहीं देगी। वाई? बिकॉज ही इज हैविंग ए मेडिकल हिस्ट्री बिफोर द गिविंग द पॉलिसी। मेडिकल हिस्ट्री दैट इज हेल्थ, स्टेट ऑफ हेल्थ, स्टेट ऑफ बॉडी ऑफ ए पर्सन। सो ऐसी सिचुएशन में जो इंश्योरेंस फॉर्म है अपने आप फिल करो आप, एटलीस्ट वो वाइटल चीजें जो डिस्क्लोज करनी है आपको, दैट शुड बी फिल्ड बाई योर सेल्फ। अदरवाइज इट क्लेम तो मिलेगा ही नहीं आपको, और आपका फ्रॉडुलेंट बिहेवियर और शो करेंगे वो। सो इन दिस सिचुएशन द अर्लियर स्टेट ऑफ हेल्थ को प्रूव करने के लिए सो मेनी थिंग्स आर रेलिवेंट, लाइक अर्लियर डॉक्टर्स प्रिस्क्रिप्शन, द केस, मेडिकल केस हिस्ट्री। सो दोज फैक्ट्स आर ऑल्सो रेलिवेंट टू प्रूव द स्टेट ऑफ हेल्थ। सिमिलरली सपोज एट दैट टाइम व्हेन दैट पर्सन वॉज सफरिंग, ही वॉज टेलिंग टू सम पीपल दैट आई वॉज सफरिंग फ्रॉम सो एंड सो डिजीज। So the statement that he has made regarding the state of health, that will also be relevant to prove her state of things. Sorry, her state of health. See the explanation one. A fact relevant as showing the existence of a relevant state of mind. A fact relevant as showing the existence of a relevant state of mind must show that the state of mind exists not generally, but in reference to the particular matter in question. A fact relevant as showing the existence of a relevant state of mind must show that the state of mind exists not generally, but in reference to the particular matter in question. Now you see, suppose the question is, did A have the intention to kill B? Did A have the intention to kill B? Now the fact that we are talking about, that fact must show his intention to kill B only. That is what they are saying. The fact should not be general. Now if you prove that the A has the intention to kill people at large, मान लो आप प्रूव कर देते हो कि A ने कहा था कभी कि मैं तो सबको मार दूंगा, I will kill all. So that does not show his intention specifically to kill B. If you have to prove the intention to kill B, the state of mind, then you have to prove such fact which particularly aimed at B, which is particularly related to B. If A had said earlier that I will kill B, मैं B को नहीं छोड़ूंगा, मैं B को मार दूंगा, so this is relevant because that is directly with reference to B. But if A had said that I kill all or I kill C, D, E, so that is not related to B and therefore that fact will not be relevant. जो शब्द है इसको ध्यान से पकड़ना, अ फैक्ट रेलिवेंट एज शोइंग द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ ए रेलिवेंट स्टेट ऑफ माइंड, अ फैक्ट रेलिवेंट एज शोइंग द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ ए रेलिवेंट स्टेट ऑफ माइंड मस्ट शो दैट द स्टेट ऑफ माइंड एग्जिस्ट नॉट जनरली बट इन रेफरेंस टू द पर्टिकुलर मैटर इन क्वेश्चन. नॉट जनरली but in reference to the particular matter in question. Particular matter मतलब particular एक subject matter in the case. अब इसका एक illustration दिखाता हूँ. You see, take out the illustration I. A is charged with shooting at B. A is charged with shooting at B with intent to kill him. In order to show A's intent, the fact of A's having previously shot at B may be proved. अब यहाँ पर इट इज अ क्लियर थिंग कि आपका इंटेंशन वो क्या चेक कर रहे हैं. योर इंटेंशन दे आर एग्जामिनिंग इज दैट डिड यू हैव द इंटेंशन टू किल बी एंड व्हाट इज द फैक्ट दैट दे आर प्रूविंग दैट अर्लियर आल्सो ही हैज शॉट अपॉन बी. सो दैट शोज हिज पर्टिकुलर इंटेंट टुवर्ड्स बी एंड देयरफॉर दैट विल बी रेलिवेंट. लेकिन अगर मान लो आप प्रूव कर देते हैं दैट अर्लियर he has shot upon C and D, then does that go on to prove his intention to kill B? That goes on to prove his intention to kill C and D, but not for B. So that fact is not relevant here. Now let's see illustration O. A is tried for the murder of B by intentionally shooting him dead. A is tried for the murder of B by intentionally shooting him dead. The fact that A, on other occasions, shot at B is relevant as showing his intention to shoot B. क्योंकि पहले भी उसने B पर गोली चलाई थी, therefore, that fact is relevant. Then, the fact that A was in habit of shooting at people. The fact that A was in habit of shooting at people with intent to murder them is irrelevant. Why? Because shooting at people is a general thing. That does not show your particular intent to kill B. And therefore, ये जो है ना, habit of shooting at people, या फिर ये कह देना मैं सबको मार दूंगा, that is general and that is not particularly aimed at B. And therefore, that will not be relevant in this section. तो ये जो similar occurrence है, ये भी वैसा ही होना चाहिए जो उस subject matter से related है. अब मान लो similar occurrences तो है, उसने X, Y, Z मान लो सब पर गोली चलाई, पर क्या उसने B पर गोली चलाई थी? Answer is no, and therefore his intent to kill B is not manifest. Now see illustration P. A is tried for a crime. A is tried for a crime. The fact that he said something indicating an intention to commit that particular crime is relevant. A को किसी crime के लिए try किया गया और उसने ये कहा था कि मैं ये वाला crime करूँगा. That is relevant because that is with reference to that particular crime. The fact that he said something indicating a general disposition of to commit crime of that class is irrelevant. अब मान लो A ने कहा C को कि मैं B का murder करके रहूँगा. I will kill B. And then he kills B. So the statement you made to C is relevant because it is showing his intention particularly towards B. But suppose A ने C से कहा कि मैं दुनिया में किसी को नहीं छोड़ूंगा. मैं दुनिया में किसी को नहीं छोड़ूंगा, जिंदा नहीं छोड़ूंगा. अब किसी को भी नहीं छोड़ूंगा तो इसमें B को तो डायरेक्टली नहीं बोला A ने. And therefore that statement will not be relevant. फिर आपका जो स्टेटमेंट या कंडक्ट हो, that should be directly with reference to the particular subject matter. Subject हो या object हो, with respect to the particular subject matter. Now see illustration N. A sues B for negligence in providing him with a carriage for hire, not reasonably fit for use, whereby A was injured. अब A ने B को कोई गाड़ी दी, and which is not fit for use. He negligently gave it to A. B ने negligently A को गाड़ी दे दी, which is not fit for use, and due to which A was injured. So A files a suit against B for claiming damages. अब now the negligence of B has to be proved. अब आप उसका negligent कैसे prove करोगे? By proving that he is having the knowledge, B is having the knowledge that the carriage is defected. अब आगे पढ़ो, the fact that B's attention was drawn on other occasions to the defect of that particular carriage is relevant. अब मान लो कई लोगों ने उस particular carriage को use किया था और बताया था कि उसमें defect है. So the other people draw his attention to the defect of that carriage. That shows that he is having the knowledge of the defect in that particular carriage. And therefore that will be relevant. अब आगे, the fact that B was habitually negligent about the carriages which he led to hire is irrelevant. अब general negligent is proved by certain facts, but that does not go on to prove that he was particularly negligent towards that particular carriage only. And therefore the general negligent is irrelevant, but negligent towards that particular carriage is relevant. Now come back to the illustration C. ये पहले पढ़ा था. A sues B for damages done by a dog of B, which B knew to be ferocious. The fact that the dog had previously bitten X, Y, and Z, and they had made complaints to B are relevant. अब यहाँ पर you see that the dog has bitten X, Y, and Z. The dog is not attempted to bite A. फिर भी ये relevant क्यों है? यहाँ पर A, dog is not attempted to bite A, फिर भी relevant है. सवाल समझना, सवाल ये है कि A ने B पर shoot किया, that your dog has bitten me and you were negligent. A bee's attention was drawn to the fact that your dog is ferocious several times, and X, Y, and Z are bitten by them, by him, by the dog. Now here the question is, the dog is not ever bitten A and never tried to bite A. Still, why is the fact that the dog has bitten X, Y, and Z is relevant? Because we have to examine the subject matter, and the subject matter related to this particular case is that whether the dog is ferocious. Subject matter here is not ki A ko usne pehle bite kiya tha ki nahi. The subject matter is that otherwise dog is ferocious, and the dog is ferocious that he came to know by the earlier incidents which the people X, Y, Z told him after bitten by his dog. Now carriage wale example mein bhi, what is the subject matter? Whether this particular carriage is defective. So the people drawing the attention towards that particular carriage, that is what is relevant. Now read illustration number B. A is accused of fraudulently delivering to another person a counterfeit coin. A is accused of fraudulently delivering to another person a counterfeit coin, which at the time when he delivered it, he knew to be counterfeit. Now, maan lo mere paas bahut sare coins hain, and I gave you a coin, and that coin was counterfeit, and I am charged with fraudulently giving counterfeit coin to someone. Counterfeit coin ya jali note, whatever you call. A is accused of fraudulently delivering to another person a counterfeit coin, which at the time when he delivered it, he knew to be counterfeit. So that is an allegation that with the knowledge that the coin is counterfeit, you have delivered it to another person. Now the fact that at the time of its delivery, A was possessed of a number of other pieces of counterfeit coin is relevant. The fact that A had been previously convicted of delivering to another person as genuine a counterfeit coin, knowing it to be counterfeit, is relevant. मतलब पहले वो convict हो चुका है. अब मेरा सवाल ये है कि इसमें और carriage वाले में क्या फर्क है? क्योंकि वहाँ पर तो एक आपको particular carriage के बारे में पता था. Your attention was drawn to a particular carriage, but here we are not talking about the particular coin that you gave, but here you are dealt with counterfeit coins. You are in possession of counterfeit coins. It is not about the same coin which you have given to other. Still, how it is relevant? Now, देखो यहाँ पर subject matter कोई individual coin नहीं है. Subject matter यहाँ पर है that you are dealing with counterfeit coins. Subject matter in this is whether your dog is ferocious. Subject matter is whether that particular carriage is defected. Here the subject matter is not that particular coin is counterfeit. Now dekhi, charge to usi coin pe laga hai, but the larger issue is as to whether you deal with counterfeit coin or not. To jab aap counterfeit coin se deal kar rahe hain aur ye coin bhi counterfeit coin hai, so the here the subject matter is whether you dealt with counterfeit coins or not. And therefore yahan pe us particular coin ke bare mein koi fact nahi hai, fir bhi generally you are dealing with counterfeit coins, that becomes relevant. Ab is illustration B par aap likh lo ek sentence, write down. Here the subject matter is not just whether that particular coin was counterfeit. Here the subject matter is not just whether that particular coin was counterfeit. Rather, the question is whether the accused dealt with counterfeit or not. Therefore, whether he had the knowledge of that coin to be counterfeit, and therefore its earlier dealing with counterfeit coin will be relevant. Now, देखो इस पूरे section से क्या निकल कर आता है कि अगर आपको स्टेट ऑफ माइंड प्रूव करना है तो उसके लिए कोई एक कंडक्ट हो आपके पास, उसको आप कह सकते हो प्रीवियस कंडक्ट, या फिर आपका उसी से रिलेटेड योर इन्वॉल्वमेंट इन सिमिलर अक्रेंसेज, योर इन्वॉल्वमेंट इन सिमिलर अक्रेंसेज इन द पास्ट, सिमिलरली सम स्टेटमेंट दैट यू हैव मेड, एक स्टेटमेंट आपने किया हो, सो दैट स्टेटमेंट मे बी रेलिवेंट टू प्रूव द स्टेट ऑफ माइंड, द सिमिलर अक्रेंसेज इन विच यू आर इन्वॉल्व दैट शुड बी प्रूव्ड टू देयर स्टेट ऑफ माइंड, और एनी प्रीवियस कंडक्ट दैट यू मे हैव डन दैट कैन बी प्रूव्ड, बट वॉट एवर यू प्रूव दैट शुड बी डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू वॉट, रिलेटेड टू दैट पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट मैटर, दैट शुड बी रिलेटेड टू पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट मैटर। सोचो अगर कॉमन सेंस है कि सिमिलर अक्रेंस में आपने पार्टिसिपेट किया, सिमिलर अक्रेंस जिसमें आपने पार्टिसिपेट किया, दैट सिमिलर अक्रेंस इज अ रेलिवेंट फैक्ट, द सिमिलर अक्रेंस इन विच ही वॉज पार्टिसिपेटेड, दैट सिमिलर अक्रेंस इज अ रेलिवेंट फैक्ट, दैट सिमिलर अक्रेंस इन विच ही वॉज पार्टिसिपेटेड, दैट इज अ रेलिवेंट फैक्ट, एंड उसी सिमिलर अक्रेंस में ही वॉज अर्लियर कन्विक्टेड, उसी सिमिलर अक्रेंस में अगर आप पहले कन्विक्ट हो चुके हो, देन इज नॉट द प्रीवियस कन्विक्शन ऑल्सो अ रेलिवेंट फैक्ट, फॉर एग्जाम्पल ए सॉट अपॉन बी अर्लियर ऑल्सो दैट इज रेलिवेंट, एंड सिंस ए वॉज प्रोसिक्यूटेड एंड पनिश्ड फॉर अर्लियर शूटिंग, देन दैट प्रीवियस कन्विक्शन इज ऑल्सो रेलिवेंट। अब एक्सप्लेनेशन टू इज टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट ओनली, एक्सप्लेनेशन टू, बट वेयर अपॉन द ट्रायल ऑफ ए पर्सन एक्यूज्ड ऑफ एन ऑफेंस द प्रीवियस कमीशन बाय द एक्यूज्ड ऑफ एन ऑफेंस इज रेलिवेंट विद इन द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस सेक्शन, देन द प्रीवियस कन्विक्शन ऑफ सच पर्सन शैल ऑल्सो बी अ रेलिवेंट फैक्ट। अब सपोज आपने ए को गोली मारी आज, ए मर गया, अब पहले भी आपने गोली मारी थी उसको, सो इफ द प्रीवियस कमीशन ऑफ द सिमिलर अक्रेंस इज रेलिवेंट, देन ऑब्वियसली इफ ही वॉज कन्विक्टेड फॉर दैट ऑफेंस अर्लियर, देन द प्रीवियस कन्विक्शन ऑफ दैट ऑल्सो बी रेलिवेंट। अब इलिस्ट्रेशन बी में आपका यही तो कह रहा है, द फैक्ट दैट ए हैड बीन प्रीवियसली कन्विक्टेड ऑफ डिलीवरिंग टू अनदर पर्सन एज जेन्युइन ए काउंटरफीट कॉइन नोइंग इट टू बी काउंटरफीट इज रेलिवेंट, सो प्रीवियस अक्रेंस भी रेलिवेंट होगा, प्रीवियस अक्रेंस भी रेलिवेंट होगा, एंड प्रीवियस कन्विक्शन फॉर दैट ऑल्सो बी रेलिवेंट। अब दैट्स इट फॉर दिस सेक्शन, एंड प्लीज रिवाइज दिस सेक्शन, आई विल नॉट से दैट इट इज अ डिफिकल्ट वन, बट आपको रिवाइज करना है, बेयर एक्ट को ही बार बार पढ़ना है, इलस्ट्रेशंस को ही पढ़ना है, रिवाइज द इलस्ट्रेशंस केयरफुली, क्योंकि क्वेश्चन आ जाते हैं इलस्ट्रेशंस में डायरेक्टली मीन्स में, खास करके जो फर्स्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन है उसको ज़्यादा रिवाइज करिएगा। और एक बात ध्यान रखना कि कोई भी बात जो आपका स्टेट ऑफ माइंड बताता हो, एनी थिंग विच टेल्स द स्टेट ऑफ माइंड विल बी रेलिवेंट, इट कैन बी प्रीवियस कंडक्ट, इट कैन बी सिमिलर अक्रेंस, इट कैन बी प्रीवियस कन्विक्शन, इट कैन बी स्टेटमेंट, एनी सच थिंग विच रिवील्स योर स्टेट ऑफ माइंड विल बी रेलिवेंट अंडर दिस सेक्शन। अब ये सारे फैक्ट्स बता नहीं रहे, दे आर सेइंग एनी फैक्ट, दे आर सेइंग फैक्ट्स शोइंग द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ एनी स्टेट ऑफ माइंड। अब व्हाट फैक्ट्स शोइंग दैट दे आर नॉट सेइंग, व्हाट फैक्ट्स दे आर नॉट सेइंग अबाउट इट, इट कैन बी एनी फैक्ट, इट कैन बी स्टेटमेंट, इट कैन बी एनी अदर थिंग। सो दैट्स इट फॉर दिस लेक्चर एंड दिस सेक्शन, थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग लेक्चर। In the next lecture, we would continue with section 15. Thank you.